All right, welcome back, guys. Today we're just going to be talking about tractors, our tractors, and maybe setups that we want. All right, we're starting off with Max Gilbert.
All right, kicking off the list, we got a 7120. We got ours on a feed wagon. Both of ours are on feed wagons. It's not funny.
What?
They're on balers sometimes, bale processor, and that's about it. Aiden.
I'm going to go with 4255, one of my favorites, just all around versatile, goes about anything that I want. It's perfect for us. How about you, Cash?
John Deere 4450, use it on the feed wagon, bale processor, sometimes the haybine, pretty much anything.
Cash, don't you also have a payloader?
Yeah.
How many do you have? Just one?
Two.
What are they?
Cats. One's a 926M. It's a 2019. The other one's a 1998 IT28G cat. The one is 20,000 hours on it. And the one just hit 4,000. We bought the newer one new.
What do you use for, like, feeding cattle and stuff like that?
For feeding. For loading the feed wagon, we got our 7140. It's got a loader on it. We have a payloader, but
yeah, we don't talk about that no
more. Hydraulic oil really bad, and it overheated, and now it is currently sitting
typical Daywood. Yeah. Just
yeah.
It's nice while it lasted. Well, a year.
Next tractor we got that I got is a 7140. I guess the one that's got the loader on it. One of my favorite tractors. And we kind of use it all around. Aiden?
What's your feeding setup?
We just have a tractor and a loader hooked to it. We have a 6M135, and then we just hook up a loader to it, and that's how we get around with it.
Then don't you have a 7920 on the wagon?
Yep.
That's what we mix around.
Well, the rest of our setup, we got a couple vertical mixers, and they're both on 4450s. They're high hours, so don't worry about it. But yeah, then we got the new payload. That's our seating, or that's our setup in the morning. So yeah.
We have a farm-aid 540, I think, is what it is. 430. I don't know. I don't remember what it is, but we
good old farm-aid.
We got a couple of those, and then we got a night wagon.
How long, Cash? How long does it normally take you to, like, do, like, chores in the morning or, like?
We start at, like, 8, about 11.
Interesting.
Takes a little while.
How about you, Max?
Extra hour for the breakdown for Max.
No, they don't break down. Probably about.
Only on days that end in Y, right?
About an hour.
About an hour, yeah, that's where I'm at as well.
Yeah.
So do you guys have, like, a bunch of, like, feedlot cattle or, like?
Yeah, it's called calf operation. We take off the mother. We keep the, well, since it's out of so many cows, we only have 100 and some heifers. So we sort off the really nice ones so that we can get money off the ones that we don't like. And then we keep the steers and fatten them out. And then we just keep cycling in. I think our oldest cow right now is 14 years old right now. So she's still producing. And looks like a 10-year-old cow.
That's basically what we do as well. We have two pastures, though. Well, we have three, but we basically have our, like, farmyard, and then we have cattle, like, a mile west of our house. And then, so it takes a lot of time just going down back and forth.
Yeah.
What about you, Maxie Boo?
We also run a cow-calf operation, but my dad, he buys more calves. He doesn't fatten them up to get fats, till they're fats.
Doesn't he just do it for, like, a couple months?
He just feeds them
for
a couple months and then sells them.
Yeah, like trades kind of around and trying.
Yeah, and then our cows are out at a pasture. Yeah.
Actually, we just hauled to about 113 out the grass the last couple days, so just starting now.
Yeah, ours have been out there since last year. We just
what do they get to eat out there?
We feed them out there.
Oh,
you guys. That's so like in pastures, like you said, you feed them out there. Do you use like old tires from like tractors and stuff, or what do you
no,
like?
No, we just pile it on the ground out there.
Oh. We use like pan bunks, and we got all types of bunks, like 10 different types, for some reason. We got like ones that are straight, and then they got a bar on the top to pick them up. We got just Mac metal bunks, and then we use tire bunks. We just use. I mean, we all kind of got the same type, I'm sure. Just a mix.
So, assuming we all move cattle with like a trailer and stuff. So, like, what do we have going on like for our trailer and truck?
We got a couple setups, but it depends. Normally, it'd be a 2002 Duramax on a 24-foot Titan trailer, and a 2014 Duramax on a 24 Featherlight trailer. But my dad's also got a 18 Duramax, so sometimes that's on the Featherlight, but most of the time it's not. You, Max?
Yeah, we got my dad's 2010 Chevy 2500. It's a gas. It's got almost 200,000. It's got like 190,000 miles on it.
Yeah, it's got pretty much the same trailer as ours. It's black though.
Yeah, ours is black.
But yeah, it's basically the exact same trailer. The Titan.
We just got one horse trailer. And my uncle has two though.
Wait, Max, you have horses?
No.
Good one.
You're hilarious.
Your setup?
Well, we use like a truck, so it's a 2006 Volvo.
I love that.
And so yeah. And we can fit like 40 on our trailer about one time.
Yeah. We got, I forgot about that. Cole's got my brother, he's got a, it's a 2007 P379. And we got just a old 53-foot Wilson on there. But we kind of want to get a ground load, but I don't know if that'll ever happen or not.
My dad's truck, I think, is a 2009, maybe. I don't remember what year it is.
But he just custom hauls, or you guys use it yourself sometimes?
We use it ourselves sometimes. We also custom hauls for people. But he works for a guy, and the trailer's a triple axle. I don't know how long it is.
It'd be longer than
it's
53.
Yeah, it's probably.
Or wait, maybe. Yeah, maybe ours is like a 48 then.
I have no idea.
Because ours is just a tandem. So it's probably like a 48-footer then.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, but.
Yeah.
We have other trucks. We've got two Mack trucks. One's a 2016 and 2015. Do you have, like, other grain trucks, or do you just, like.
Yeah, we got two trucks. One's, like, one's pretty old. But it's a really good truck. It's a 95 Volvo, and I think it's got a Detroit in it. And it's over, like, a million or something. Same with the 379.
My dad's truck is over a million. It just hit a million the last month, I think.
Is it the red one?
Yeah.
The guy rebuilt? Yeah, that's a nice truck.
We have two other trucks, too. Usually we use the other two for grain. Well, my dad hauls cows in the fall sometimes. One's like a 97, but the International. It's white, just day cab. I think that one's got a Detroit. Or maybe it's a cat, I don't know. It's
yeah.
A cat or Detroit. Then we got a 2001 or two International. It's got a sleeper on it.
Is that the blue one?
Yeah.
I like that one.
Yeah, I think that one's got I think that one has a Detroit.
Yeah.
So is your stick?
Our trucks?
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't have an automatic truck.
Ours are too. Stick. You guys have automatic?
Yeah.
Both of them?
No, except for our Volvo that we use for cattle.
Oh. But the other two are.
Yeah.
I guess the Pete's got a cat in it. It was rebuilt. I don't know when it was. So it's probably only got like 400,000 on it or something. But it's clocked over a million now.
Yeah, I think ours have around. Yeah, I think ours have around 400,000.
Yeah, we don't use ours very much. Just, we don't really combine much, just because it's all for the cattle, so we don't really sell much of it. And then hauling cattle, and then sometime they'll help out neighbors or whatever, haul cattle, but we don't really use it that much.
Yeah, we don't, like, we don't really keep much grain. Like, we keep grain for our, like, cattle to, like, grind it up and stuff. But, like, most of our, like, grain that we get, we just sell. We put in bins and then sell it later.
Oh. We don't really have much bin storage, but we don't really need any because we pretty much put every single bit of it back into the cattle.
Yeah.
So, we'll sell beans usually if we have them. That's pretty much our only grain income.
Yeah.
Yeah, we sell some of our corn. We put usually fill one or two bins. We have three at our place. One or two of corn. Sometimes we'll fill one with beans. And, yeah, we'll usually use one of those bins of corn for put it back into the cows and sometimes sell the other one.
So do you guys only stick to corn and beans, or you, like, include wheat or stuff like that?
Well, we bought a drill a couple years ago, and we just use it to plant, like, barley, or I don't know if it's barley. Oh, it's just all good feed for rye, just stuff like that.
And then do you bale it, like?
Usually, or we chop it, but usually we just bale it.
Yeah, we just have corn and beans, and we have a drill, too. We just, you know, we planted oats this year. I don't know if we're done with it or not yet. But
yeah. Well, I think that's going to wrap up our video for today, and we'll